when the blue of the night,
oh, you're flashing,
meets the gold of the day. Someone.
Hate to pay him by the note, huh?
Welcome to you to Philco Radio Time, produced and transcribed in the Marine Memorial Theater in San Francisco. John Scott Trotter and his orchestra, Judd Collins with the Mayors, and Bing's guests, Dinah Shore and Burl Ives. And now, with March winds blowing across the country, here's an old tumbleweed that just rolled into town, Bing Crosby.
We're only half kidding. Tumbling tumbleweed, huh?
Tumbling tumbleweed.
How are you going to justify that, tumbling tumbleweed?
Oh, I just wanted to get the show rolling.
Well, I won't bicker. After all, I did roll into town, and Burl Ives rolled in with me.
What about Dinah Shore?
Dinah flew in.
Dinah flew?
Mm-hmm.
Is that better than Dinah flow?
Dinah flow. You're really on your toes tonight, aren't you, Bob?
Oh, yes, I sure am.
Well, come down. You look silly up there. Anyhow, Ken, we seem to have offered proof positive tonight that dialogue is not going to be our long suit.
Right.
So I think I better take refuge, fly into song. I don't know what refuge you're going to seek,
well,
but that's my
plan. I may fly into a Philco commercial.
All right, do a commercial, I'll do a song, and the loudest one will get paid tonight.
No. That's no fair. You got the rhythm airs to help you. Can I borrow some of them?
No, you get your own mob. Come on, kids. Folks, here's Sunflower. This is a fairly new novelty that paints a graphic picture of romance in romantic Kansas. I was born in Kansas, I was bred in Kansas, and when I get married, I'll be wed in Kansas. And there's a true blue gal who promised she would wait. She's a sunflower from the sunflower state. She's a sunflower, she's my sunflower, and I know we'll never part. She's a sunflower, she's my one flower, she's the flower of my heart. Troubles end in Kansas,
oh son, end in Kansas.
Everyone
you meet
will be your friend in Kansas, and they'll all be there. They're gonna help me celebrate with my sunflower from the sunflower state. She's a sunflower, she's my sunflower, and I know we'll never part. She's a sunflower, she's my one flower, she's the flower of my heart. She's a sunflower, she's my kind of flower, and I know we'll never part. She's a sunflower, she's my one flower, she's the flower of my heart. She's the flower of my heart. The sunny flower of my heart.
Very fine, Bing and gang. Really great.
How did your commercial turn out?
My commercial?
Yes.
Oh, I got so carried away with your song that I just stood there with my mouth open and nothing came out.
That can be a very dangerous thing, Ken, standing around with your mouth open.
Yeah?
That happened to a cousin of mine up in Spokane, and a family of swallows moved in.
Oh, my goodness. What'd he do?
What could he do? He had his head shingled. Now he's a birdhouse.
I've heard of him. Birdhouse Crosby.
Yes, bird brain, too.
You know, being a cousin of mine back in Peoria, stood around with his mouth open and a swarm of bees flew in.
What'd they call him? Honeychild?
No, Buzzy.
Oh.
Fuzzy, that's the one with the hives. Yeah, well, interesting as this dialogue may be, and I don't think it is, I think you better buzz into some honeyed phrases about Philco.
Well, Bing, that's not hard to do when you can talk about the world's finest table radio phonograph.
Oh, yes, the Philco 1405 is the world's finest table radio phonograph. I've got one on every table in my house.
My gosh, how many tables you got?
One.
That's all we ask, folks. No, don't overdo it. Just do it.
Right. Say, isn't there more news about the tremendous bargains at our Philco dealers right now?
But the biggest, Bing. Anytime you can save $31 and get the world's greatest performing table radio phonograph, that's red-hot news. Folks, to be exact, you can save $31.40 at your Philco dealer right now on a special limited offer. You don't spend one thin dime extra, and you get a matching mahogany table plus a library of 40 selections on non-breakable long-playing records when you pay the regular low price for the famous Philco 1405. And those dollars you save make it more than ever worthwhile to buy this great Philco table automatic now. It's a quality radio phonograph through and through, gives you glorious concert hall tone that matches what you get from big consoles costing $200 or more. And it plays both regular and long-playing records. So don't wait a day longer. Get this great money-saving offer at your Philco dealer now and get the listening thrill of your life from Philco, the leader.
Here's a fine tune written by their band leader, ex-coal miner, and Bach beer enthusiast, Mr. Russ Morgan, along with Jack Stewart.
I'm so tired of waiting for you. So tired of longing for you. Tired of waiting, saving my love for you. So tired of dreaming daydreams. So tired of only places. Why don't you call me? Call me tonight, my dear. Tell me that your thoughts are all of me, sweetheart. All day long, I wonder why we're far apart. So tired of dreaming of you. So tired of waiting for you. Though I'm tired, I'll wait forever, dear.
Thank you very much.
Hi, Bing.
Well, Diana Shore. Diana, you did give me a start. You took me by surprise, breezing in like that. I was going to give you a big introduction, you know, a long build-up before you took your bow.
Oh, no long build-up.
Why not?
I'm not going to stand around with my mouth open. I heard you and Ken talking about your cousin.
Well, what happened to Birdhouse and Buzzy rarely happens, Dinah. They're more or less freaks.
Oh, I don't know, Bing. I had a cousin down in Tennessee who was laying down sleeping with his mouth open while they were building the golf course.
No kidding. What happened?
Well, they stuck a flag in his mouth, and he is now the 17th hole at the Chattanooga Country Club.
Well, look here. I've played that course, Dinah. Number 17 is the only hole in the country that snaps at you when you reach in for your ball.
Well, that's my cousin Cupmouth.
Old Cuppy, huh?
Oh,
well, look at
here. He was always pretty hungry.
In view of this absorbing disclosure, Dinah, I can understand why you don't want to stand around with your mouth. While I give you the big bill, then.
Oh, well, that's not the only reason, Bing, really. I just don't think it's natural for you to give me a tremendous welcome and then act so surprised that I'm here. After all, we've been here together all afternoon.
I know it, Dinah, and you know it, and the people know it, but there's an old law that was written years ago in some obscure advertising agency that makes it mandatory for everybody in radio to be constantly as enthusiastic as the top man on a pyramid club.
It's really an old law, huh?
Old law? Why, it was written when Bat and Barton, Durston and Osborne were just Bootsy, Bootsy, Stinky and Ducky. That's years and years. That goes back.
Well, sir, I'm very happy to say that's before my time.
Your hand.
Thank you very much. Anyway, Bing, I'm glad you cleared it up for me. For a long time, I've wondered why everybody in radio is always so full of
charm?
Thank you. I was sort of searching for a word. All of us in radio are constantly enthusiastic,
mm-hmm.
effervescent,
mm-hmm.
so full of...
Would charm work again?
Well, it better.
I know what you mean, Don. I know really everybody is so hyperthyroid.
They are?
Tizzy. Everybody's just in a tizzy. Did you ever listen to Betty Cheesecake's cooking class of the air?
Oh, yes, and she has wonderful recipes.
Yeah, but she shouts them out like she's announcing the Kentucky Derby. Sounds like Clem McCarthy in the stretch. Did you ever hear her recipe for mock shortcake?
Oh, no, but I did catch her recipe for 7-minute seafoam icing.
Oh.
That's for people who live down by the beach.
That must be a rouser. I'll bet this is... Where do I get my pencil? I don't want to miss a word of this.
I can remember almost every word
Wait
of it.
Wait a minute now.
All right,
my...
you got your pencil?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Good morning, housewives. This is Betty Cheesecake in her magic oven.
Oh.
This morning we've got a peachy dandy recipe for 7-minute seafoam icing. But before we give you the recipe for the icing, we'll have to teach you how to bake a cake so you'll have something to put the icing on.
Not... Not necessarily. You can always use it for shaving cream or plaster up chinks in the walls.
And this morning I've got a special surprise for you. One of the most delicious cakes I've ever invented. Tasmanian onion cake. First you take a 1/2 pound of garlic.
An onion cake?
Well, this will kill the odor of the onion.
May kill the people.
Now, into the bowl, shake 2 teaspoons of flour, 2 cups of baking powder, 3 quarts of milk. And fold into this a large hogshead of vanilla. Oh, now get your mop. The bowl's running over.
Say, Miss Cheesecake, before you go, I know that our audience would just love to know what you do, what they should do with party leftovers.
Well, I usually call a cab for them.
Oh, they're coming. They're with us. I think they just joined us there.
And of course, if they don't go willingly, I call the police.
Thank you, Betty Cheesecake, and your magic oven. Let us turn our attention to Miss Dinah Shore, who is set to bounce into a bubbly thing from Cole Porter's big Broadway musical, Kiss Me, Kate. Which one of Cole's smash tunes are you going to sing, Dinah?
Always True to You, Darling, in My Fashion.
Is that the title or the first chorus? Don Scott, start it. I'll find out about this thing right now.
She's always true to her darling in her fashion. Yeah, she's always true to her darling in her way.
If a custom tailored vet asks me out for something wet, when the vet begins to pet, I cry, hooray! But I'm always true to you, darling, in my fashion. Yes, I'm always true to you, darling, in my way. I've been asked to have a meal by a big tycoon in steel. If the meal includes a deal, accept I may. But I'm always true to you, darling, in my fashion. Yes, I'm always true to you, darling, in my way. There's an oil man known as Texas.
calls me up from night to morn. Miss the thorn once cornered corn. That ain't hay.
But she's always true to her darling in a fashion.
Oh, yes. I'm always true to you, baby, in my way. Mr. Harris, plutocrat, likes to give my cheek a pat. If a Harris pat means a Paris hat, baby!
Ooh la la!
But she's always true to her darling in a fashion.
Oh, yes, I'm always true to you, darling, in my way.
So true.
An old sidekick of mine and a fast friend of folks who favor sweet music from the heart of America is the gentleman currently approaching our microphone. Let's give a big warm reception to a big warm wandering troubadour, Burl Ives.
Thanks, folks, and thank you too, Bing. That was a mighty nice introduction.
Well, it's easy, Burl, to introduce an artist like yourself. After all, you stand alone in your field.
So does the scarecrow.
No, I meant that as a compliment, Burl. No offense.
Well, don't worry, Bing. Why, some of my best friends are scarecrows.
Is that so? Well, yeah. I could use a few good ones up at the ranch. The birds have been stealing my corn.
Well, that's show business for you.
No, I mean the corn my cattle eat. Hey, Burl, where have you been operating lately? I haven't...
Oh, I've been all over, Bing.
Oh, that's right. You're on a concert tour this year.
Yeah. Huh? You know, Bing, you ought to do concerts. Get out on the road and travel.
Me? Concerts? I'm quite a target, you know. I don't think I should. I've had my fill of traveling, Burl. By my day, when I was the drummer, vocalist, and applause starter for the Spokane Serenaders, we traveled to every city, village, and hamlet in the country.
Well, that must have been a long time ago.
Well, just to give you an idea, Lewis and Clark were my advance men.
Anyway, Bing.
Publicity hung my billboards.
Anyway, Bing, I still think that you ought to go out on a little tour again and let the people see you in the flesh.
Well, that might be a good idea. I've got a lot of new flesh they've never seen. But, Burl, I don't cotton to this road caper much. I'm going to hold off and wait for television. That'll scoop me around the country.
Why, television's just like movies without the popcorn.
Yeah, but first thing you know, they'll be shoving popcorn machines in the living rooms, too. I hear that Philco's working on a combination radio phonograph television corn popper now.
Is that so? Mm-hmm. Well, I don't know if I'd like that. Butter running down all over my radio.
A little butter wouldn't hurt the radio. Can you imagine Al Jolson sautéed?
Why, isn't he already?
No. He's souffléed. He's on for Kraft cheese. That's au gratin. Say, Burl, I guess you and I, though, really are headed straight for television.
Hey,
it's inevitable.
Wait a minute now. You can't run off into television and leave me just standing
Well,
here.
Of course not, Dinah. I think we all have something to worry about in television.
What's that?
Well,
mean?
In radio, we have scripts to hold. Gives us something to do. But in television, what do we do with our hands?
I don't know about you, Bing, but I can always milk a goat.
You don't need a goat. You got a guitar to play with.
I can play the guitar, too. I don't like to mention it.
Personally, I never got past the ukulele.
Say, hey, I got a couple of brand new ukuleles right here.
Oh, yeah?
Really?
Yeah, aren't they cute?
Oh.
Aren't they cute as the dickens? Where'd you get them?
Well, I opened up my guitar case this morning to look at my guitar, and there they were.
You're wonderful.
Oh, it sure is.
Here, be careful. Be careful. Here, you take
Thanks.
One.
At this point, there'll be a slight lull while the man brings me the guitar. They had to carry, carry, carry to the ferry. They had to carry, carry, carry to the shore. And the reason why they had to carry, carry to the ferry was because Carrie couldn't carry anymore.
Hey, Bing, you know, that's really something.
I'll tell you what. Dinah, you and Burl get your guitars, and we'll serenade the folks.
Oh, wait a minute now. The only tune I know is Clementine, and it's got to be in the key of C.
Well, you play in the key of C, and Burl and I will check with you from time to time. We may come out pretty even. Burl, you got your guitar?
Yeah, sir.
Chords.
In a canyon, in a cavern, excavating for a mine.
Dwelt a miner, 49er.
And his daughter, Clementine.
Interlude.
Ready?
Ready.
Oh, my darling Clementine. Now I've gone, but not forgotten. Oh, my darling Clementine.
Interlude.
We are little black sheep who have...
Just a minute, I have an interlude coming. An interlude.
Burl.
Old drove she ducklings to the water every morning just at 9.
Now Dinah Shore is supposed to sing.
Get her foot again, I can't.
Clementine, plant
you now and dig you later, like a tiger, Clementine. Hey, Burl, I really think that the people all over the country are going to hate us if Burl don't redeem us now by singing one of the wonderful songs that he's made so famous. Burl, what would you like to...
I'd like to sing Lavender Blue.
Oh, from the Disney picture, so dear to my heart. I'd really like to hear that. Ready, Burl? I'm ready. Oh.
Great-grandfather met great-grandmother when she was a shy young miss. And great-grandfather won great-grandmother with words more or less like this. Lavender blue, dilly-dilly, lavender green. If I were king, dilly dilly, I'd need a queen. Who told me so, dilly dilly? Who told me so? I told myself, dilly dilly, I told me so. If your dilly dilly heart feels a dilly dilly way, and if you answer yes, in a pretty little church on a dilly dilly day, you'll be wed in a dilly-dilly dress of lavender blue, dilly-dilly, lavender green. Then I'll be king, dilly-dilly, and you'll be my queen.
Very lilting, Burl. And folks, down at your Philco dealer now, you'll hear more lilting music. It's the music of money in your pocket, a solid cash savings of $31.40 on the most sensational radio phonograph offer of the year. You don't want to lose any time because this is a special limited offer. But while it lasts, your Philco dealer will include at no extra charge a matching mahogany table valued at $20 and a library of 40 selections on long playing records with your purchase of the world's greatest table radio phonograph, the Philco 1405. Now, don't miss this once-in-a-blue-moon value, friends. You get a table automatic that plays both regular and long-playing records with matchless quality of tone, plus the mahogany table and the 40 long-playing record selections. And you put $31.40 in your pocket on the combination. It's all made possible by the resources of the world's largest radio manufacturer, Philco, famous for quality the world over.
Here's a song called Faraway Places. Seems appropriate enough inasmuch as we're broadcasting from San Francisco, one of the great gateways of the world. This may build a mood and the whole entourage will take off for Petaluma.
Faraway places with strange sounding names. Faraway over the sea. too, with a strange sounding name, are calling, calling me. Go into China, or maybe Siam. I want to see for myself those far away places I've been reading about in a book that I took from the shelf. I start getting restless whenever I hear the whistle of a train. I pray for the day I can get underway and look for those castles in Spain. They call me a dreamer. Well, maybe I am, but I know that I'm burning to see those far away places with a strange sounding name calling.
Just about get it. You get it. Now, thanks to Dinah Shore and Burl Ives for joining up with us tonight.
It's nice being here, Bing. And incidentally, I want to thank you for playing my records on your disc jockey show.
Oh, yes. I'm on for a Minute Maid fresh frozen orange juice. It's delicious. Say, Burl, before you go, would you autograph a copy of your book for me?
Oh, did you buy a copy of Wayfaring Stranger, Bing?
I sure did, and it was delicious, too.
Who's on with you next week,
oh,
Bing?
Oh, next, Dinah, we have a delicious show. A big jazzy bash is going to bust right out here. We've got Peggy Lee, Louis Armstrong, Jack Teagarden, and Joe Venuti. They're all going to be aboard. We really ought to break it up pretty good with that ensemble. That aggregation of stars.
Yeah. It
sounds tasty.
That sounds pretty jumpy to me.
Oh, it'll leap like limber lumber, I promise you. Good night, Dinah.
Good night, Bing.
So long, Bing.
So long, Burl. Good night, folks, and thank you very much.
This program was produced and transcribed in San Francisco by Bill Morrow and Murdo MacKenzie. Tune in to Philco Radio Time next week and hear Bing Crosby, John Scott Trotter and his orchestra, Judd Collins with the Mayors, and Bing's guests, Peggy Lee, Louis Armstrong, Jack Teagarden, and Joel Venuti. And remember, keep your eye on your Philco dealer now for the greatest values in radio phonographs from Philco, the leader.